Hello, and welcome to another Lumbridge Night quest guide for free-to-play OSRS. In this video, we're going to be looking at the Below Ice Mountain quest. This quest is one of the newer free-to-play quests and grants access to the Ruins of Camdozaal dungeon. You will need 16 quest points in order to start the quest, and either enough combat to defeat a level 25 Ancient Guardian, or level 10 mining and any pickaxe. The only items you will need is a loaf of bread and a knife. To speed things up, a Falador, Varrock and Skull Scepter teleport will be useful, along with the statutory energy or stamina potions. In order to get the loaf of bread, I suggest you check out my video on the cook's assistant. But in essence, head to Port Sarum and buy a pot of flour. It might be best to buy two in case you burn your first attempt. Then head back to Lumbridge Castle Kitchen. Once in the castle kitchen, grab a jug and fill it with water. Grab a knife while you're at it too. Then make some bread dough with the water and flour and use it on the oven, assuming you've done the cook's assistant quest. If not, you'll need to head into Alcarad and use the stove there. With the two items we need in hand, head to the middle of the road between Falador and the Barbarian Village, pretty much directly south of the entrance to the Dwarven Mines. You should find Willow there. Speak to her and accept the quest. After the short narrative, you agree to go speak to the other three members of her gang. Checkal is in the Barbarian Village, so head directly east from speaking with Willow. You should be able to see Checkal by the eastern entrance to the village. Speak to him and he will tell you you must train with Atlas before he will speak to you. Head north and into the Longhouse. Before speaking to Atlas, however, grab a cooked meat and a beer from one of the tables, as we'll need them later. Then speak to Atlas and ask for some training. After a Rocky-style montage, he will declare your training complete and you will unlock the Flex emote. Head back to Checkal and he will ask you to show the results of your training. Use the Flex emote in front of him and he will agree to rejoin Willow's crew. Next up, head north to the graveyard in Edgeville. Near the yew trees, you will find Marley. Speak to him and ask him to rejoin the crew. He will request a steak sandwich from the Blue Moon Inn in Varrock. Agree to get him one, and once you've finished talking, pop a Varrock teleport. From the square in Varrock, head south and into the kitchen in the Blue Moon Inn.
Please like the video and support my content. Thank you, noble knight.
Once there, speak to the chef and ask for a steak sandwich. He will twig that you are asking for Marley and refuse to give you a sandwich, but he will give you the recipe. Once the conversation is done, use the knife on the bread to make the steak sandwich. Return to Marley with the sandwich. The fastest route is to use the Skull Scepter to get to the Barbarian Village and then run north from there. Once you're back in Edgeville, deliver the sandwich and he will agree to rejoin the crew. Now pop a Falador teleport. You'll find Burtof in the pub just southwest of the town square. Head inside and speak to him. He will immediately request you buy him a beer. Luckily, we picked one up in the Barbarian Village, so we can give him that. After a brief chat, he will agree to return to the crew if you beat him at Rock, Paper, Scissors. Hint, you can't lose, so pick whatever and he will assume he loses and agree to come back. Head to the west side of Ice Mountain and you will find Willow and the crew assembled. Remember to bring your melee gear and food if you need it to fight the level 25 golem, or the pickaxe if you aren't opting for the fight option. Agree to head into the ruins, and after a short cutscene, you'll end up with Willow and her crew. They will then attempt to double cross you. Lucky for them, a guardian golem attacks, and they run away leaving you to deal with it. You have two options here. you can fight it and kill it, or mine each of the four pillars around the room. Whichever way you choose to defeat the golem, kill it, and after a quick cutscene where you rummage through Willow's bag, the quest complete window will pop. Congratulations, you've completed another quest, and you will now get access to Camdozaal, 2k coins, and a quest point. Just before we finish, make sure you speak to Romano before you go to unlock the Baronite Forge. And that brings us to the end of this video. I hope that this Below Ice Mountain quest guide was useful. Please leave a comment with any feedback or questions, as I'm keen to hear them. And all that's left for me to say is I've been the Lumbridge Knight, peace out, and thanks for watching.